with Red Dead Redemption 2, was that your first experience using mocap?
No, I did it before here, actually, somewhere near Oxford, I believe. It was for a studio. It was a joint production by Rebellion Games and Eidos. And that was about 16 years ago. And we did a game called Shell Shock 2, which is a lot of zombies and Vietnamese and Vietnam War. And it was a lot of fun. And I was fascinated from then about that medium. It's fascinating to me. And to see the way the technology has progressed since has been a real privilege. It's I love it. I love performance capture. I love it a lot. As it gets better and better, it just affords more and more freedom to the performers. It's really cool. Takes a lot of imagination, but it's I love it.
Yeah. Where do you think it's going to evolve next? Would you?
Well, I think voice acting is still a significant part of it, but performance capture is becoming a bigger and bigger and ever increasing section of it. You know, like 20 years ago, it was all exclusively voice acting. Maybe not exclusively, but performance capture is definitely here to stay. And like I was saying earlier, seeing that technology unfold in front of your very eyes has been a massive privilege, you know, and I'm just fascinated by the whole concept of it, because you have a mocap studio and you're in Antarctica in the morning and you're in medieval England the afternoon, and all it changes really is the animators and the developers' imagination. So it's a fantastic medium. And even with COVID too, it's been, you know, it's a lot safer to work in a mocap environment than would you like a typical film set, you know, because you can cheat. People don't need to be standing right next to each other. You know, the animators can do that in post. You can even change the camera angle in post if you want. You know, what you think could be a wide shot could actually turn into a close-up in the end. So bearing that in mind, as an actor, you start to think, well, I know what they think this shot might be now, but that could change in the future. So you tend to lean a bit more towards the theatrical than as the little subtle little nuances of film performance, you know. It's really only in cutscenes where you get close-ups, you know, and most of the time they're going for as wide a shot as possible so that the gamer can see as much of their environment as possible. So it does add for a bit more physicality, I think. But, you know, there's so many different ways to do it, and no two studios do it the same way, and it's really fascinating to see the way different people work and whatnot. I just see it becoming a bigger, bigger part of the video game industry, and we're starting to see that happen with the film industry now too. I think it's only a matter of time before we start seeing mocap suits filmed in tandem with on set. You know, we're kind of seeing that already with Mark Ruffalo and as the Hulk, and I think Disney and Marvel have done some really fascinating stuff. And now with Obi-Wan Kenobi, I can't wait. That technology that they did for The Mandalorian, that was amazing. So, yeah, on-set location filming, I think, is becoming less and less necessary. But when that happens, the performer needs to be more imaginative. If you're in a cold environment, you got to remember to be cold. If it's a hot, sweaty environment, you got to be swatting flies every once in a while. So I think motion capture, when you get experienced at it and you start to remember those little details, and that brings the realism to the audience that I think we're still going to need. But as far as the technology is going, I have no idea where they're going with it, but I'm sure it's going to keep going. Yeah.
Talked about motion capture and the possibilities. Do you feel that this has helped you adapt in such a way that you can improvise a bit more and bring sort of a bit more element of yourself into the character?
Absolutely. You know, I mean, some like I said, some studios do it differently. But the performer can really bring in a lot more nuances of their own personality, if you will. But again, it depends on the script. You know, you work with the script you're given. You know, you can complain and argue with it, but, you know, that usually doesn't bode well. You know, we've all got jobs to do, so it's our job to do them. Absolutely. I think there's a lot of performance capture lends a lot of freedom to all aspects of the performance. Absolutely.